inaugural session, Mr. Sabyasachi Das, he explained the about the importance of rainfed area that it is playing in the national agriculture scenario and the problems of that rainfed areas. And he gave one very important data that 23 hectare of land is going for desertification per minute in our country. So by the time this conference was started and it will end, more than 10,000 hectares will have gone under degradation across the country. And that's the scenario where we are meeting, and we have to evolve a policy framework and other intervention that is required to stop this. Dr. Ashok Dalvai, he emphasized that there are three key stakeholders: people, farmers, and ecology. And farmer will have, everybody has got a stake, and this has to be done in a very challenging scenario where the natural resources, land and water, agriculture will be under pressure to part with both of these, and we will have to make it happen in such a manner that it becomes not only productive but also remunerative for all the stakeholders. Secretary DOLR, in his address, tried to cover up all the issues related to land degradation, but he primarily focused on the data sources for the your rainfed in the land degradation area. There are 3-4 agencies, all of them have different data, so he wanted that all these agencies should concur to have one data so that we can take it forward and we can plan for that. The other issues were in regard to watershed management program. Perhaps it has lost some steam after being part of PMKSY. And the other issue that he raised was about the per hectare norms of watershed development, plus the funding pattern that also needs to be re-looked into if we have to address the issue of the land degradation. In the second session, the watershed management and land degradation neutrality was the main area for discussion. And Joint Secretary DOLR, Sri Umar Khan, presented a picture of how the watershed movement has basically progressed in our country and what are the achievements. He gave many achievements, but at the same time, he had also the issues of your data plus your other management issues, plus the main problem, which he said that of late the state governments are not forthcoming for accessing the fund and the watershed program due to various reasons. So one of them is your, of course, is funding pattern. Then Mr. Sandeep Yadav, he from water, he gave many models wherein he tried to depict that the watershed model was the best model, risk to value approach is the best for effective management of soil water. And he talked about water stewardship and participatory water budgeting, more crop per drop, your community driven seed system and sustainable agriculture practices. He also talked about measuring the changes in soil organic carbon and eco assessment of nutrient management practices. Besides that, he put emphasis on farmer friendly agro advisories and use of a common platform for issuing agro advisories and multi-layer farming for food and nutritional security. Dr. Rajiv Singh from Indian Institute of Soil Water Conservation, he gave a picture of challenges that is being faced by our country at vis-a-vis land degradation. And he was of the opinion that we do have all the technology in our command. The only issue is that how it can be transferred and how it can become a social movement. That was his view. And then the third session was in LD and soil conservation, in which JSINM gave a detailed information in regard to soil health management and what are the problems that have come into it and how this can be taken forward. The main issue was that its acceptance by many farmers, like your grid, in grid system, what she emphasized that the farmers are not ready to have sample taken from one land holding, and the entire grid is being given the soil health certificate. All of them want to have samples taken from their field. So she talked about a new approach that they have identified certain villages where the land degradation in very soil is in very bad condition, and they have those villages have been identified based on various criteria, and the entire samples from all the land holding has been taken in those villages, and the real is to be analyzed, and then how this works out, this will have to be seen. Then Mr. Rajiv Ahal from GIZ, he talked about the various types of programs that they have undertaken, and he also talked about the agroecological aspects of policies that can be worked out, agro advisories, and then he gave a vivid description about UP NRM program that they are implementing. He also talked about green innovation center approach, and then soil and water, how can they be brought in, how can they be considered in one go in together they can be considered. Then after that, Dr. Rajeshwari Raina, she primarily talked about ki people should be at center, and technology, and not people should be at the center and not the technology. And she talked about 3 M: soil moisture, soil microbes, and soil biomass. And the 4th M latter was added as money to incentivize the farmers. And she also emphasized on the getting community involvement in achieving project goals. And for taking all these together, she was of the opinion that there is a need to have a national policy for living soils. And on that basis, she wanted to have 100 pilots done in different areas of the country to see the outcome of those pilots, and then based on those pilots we can further move on. In the 4th session was incentivizing investment in your land for land degradation. Dr. Ravindra talked about the efforts that have been made that are being made by the government, and he was of the opinion that the investment coming into land is very, very meager, and so we need to have a reorientation. And then he was also of the opinion that people do not have money in the, particularly in rainfed area, to invest in the land, so there is need for more and more government funding for that. After that, he also talked about the moisture and aquifer recharge management, that is an essential component for to be addressed for land degradation. And he talked about a few things: mobilizing communities on land husbandry, make dryland farming remunerative, and sharing of governance and groundwater, sustainable management of drought and climate change acts. And he was also of the opinion that the tenure rights and governance issue are also very much important in this land degradation issue. Mr. Rath gave a picture of how the investment have gone into in the rainfed area and command area, and through various data he tried to show that the investment in the rainfed area are very, very meager. And at last, there was a presentation by NABARD on what, how the investment can be brought in the rainfed area, and some of the suggestions that he gave. A few issues that he identified were large gaps in technology developed at research farms, and that was being practiced by the farmers at the grassroots level. That was the initial phase, and major problems faced by banks are scale of operation doesn't match with the economy of scale. And he also was of the opinion that there is an inherent risk in the Rainfed area, that's correct. But then bankers are not ready to take the risk for financing those areas. And because unless they are assured of responsible banking behavior from community, they will not be forthcoming. So what his suggestions were, land and water should be the integral part for addressing the LDN. And there is a need for creation of separate fund on the lines of NASC, formulation of region-specific bankable models for financing LDN investment activities by banks, and capacity building of banking institution, dedicated risk fund at national level for promoting bank investments. Besides that, he also talked about insurance of crops and interest subvention and on capital investment and subsidy for banking institutions.
That's very good.
Thank you.